This is the city with canals instead of roads. A city with gondolas instead of cars. This is the city that is sinking and flooding more and more. This is Venice. In this video, you will learn the 8 factors that cause Venice to sink and flood. Venice is in northeastern Italy, within the Veneto region. Built on 118 small islands in the Venetian lagoon. It has a humid subtropical CFA cup and climate with hot, humid summers, mild winters and year-round rainfall. Seasonal flooding, known as Acqua Alta, frequently happens, particularly during autumn and winter. The Venetian lagoon is a shallow bay located along the Adriatic Sea. Connected to the mainland by the Ponte della Libertà causeway, it's easy accessible. The city is surrounded by water, with canals serving as primary transportation routes. Situated at the northern Adriatic coastline, it has been an historic trading hub. Its unique location and structure make it one of Italy's most iconic and picturesque cities, attracting millions of visitors every year. But the city is slowly sinking and flooding regularly. You'll be surprised what is causing this. The ground beneath Venice is made up of sediment. Sediment is loose particles like sand, silt, clay, or organic material transported by natural forces like rivers and winds and deposited in layers over time. These soft sediment layers are the reason why Venice is built on wooden piles, to provide stability on the unstable ground. The wooden piles under the city do not rot because there is no oxygen. The piles become stronger over time because minerals from the water are deposited in the wood and petrify it. Above the pilings, stone and brick platforms were constructed, forming the base for the city's iconic buildings. This ingenious engineering allowed Venice to rise above the lagoon and remain stable for centuries, despite the challenges of its watery environment. There are 8 major factors that cause the city to sink and flood frequently. Land subsidence in Venice is naturally caused by the gradual compaction of soft clay and silt sediment layers beneath the city. These sediments are compressed by their own weight and the additional pressure from the city's structures, causing the ground to sink about 1 to 2 millimeters per year. Heavy buildings in Venice strain the city's delicate foundations, accelerating subsidence. Asymmetrical weight distribution causes foundation imbalances, leading to cracks and structural instability. Tourism and construction heavily burden Venice infrastructure and fragile foundations, accelerating subsidence and structural damage. Overcrowding from mass tourism overwhelms bridges, water systems and public spaces, leading to increased maintenance costs and long-term wear on the city's historical architecture. This one will probably surprise you. Tectonic movements in the region, such as the shifting of the Adriatic plate and the Apennine Mountains, contribute to Venice's natural subsidence. These movements gradually cause the ground to sink, destabilizing the foundations of the buildings and infrastructure. The shifting plates in the region can also alter the geological stability of the lagoon, affecting the balance of sedimentation and erosion. Additionally, tectonic activity increases the likelihood of minor tremors, which can weaken the already fragile foundations of Venice's historical structures. Groundwater extraction has had a significant impact on Venice, particularly in the past. It was most prominent during the first half of the 20th century, peaking in the 1950s and 60s. This practice primarily supported the growing needs of the Marghera industrial zone, located near Venice, and the city's urban water demands. Industries in Marghera required large amounts of water for production processes, while the expansion of Venice's population and infrastructure further increased demand. This groundwater extraction began to cause Venice's soil to subside significantly, leading to serious concerns about the city's stability. Eventually, groundwater extraction was greatly reduced or stopped altogether by the late 1960s, when the negative effects became apparent. Acqua Alta is the temporary flooding of Venice, mainly in autumn and winter, caused by a combination of factors. Spring tides, occurring during full or new moons, amplify gravitational forces, raising ocean levels. Strong Sirocco winds from the Sahara pick up moisture over the Mediterranean, pushing water towards Venice. Low atmospheric pressure further raise sea levels by reducing pressure on the water surface. When these three factors align at their peak, they cause severe flooding in Venice. Extreme weather, including storms and heavy rain, is increasing the risk of flooding in Venice by overloading the city's sewer systems and increased rising water levels in the lagoon. Combined with high tides and strong winds, these conditions are making flooding worse. Global sea level rise caused by climate change significantly worsens flooding in Venice. Higher water levels increase the frequency and intensity of high tides, leading to more severe and frequent flooding. Now you're probably thinking, is there a solution to this? Can we save the city from destruction? Unfortunately, the answer is not that simple. First of all, we have the MOSE system in Venice, which is a flood defense project with 78 mobile barriers that rise to block high tides, such as Acqua Alta, and protect the city from flooding. Installed at lagoon inlets, it prevents seawater from entering during extreme tides, addressing rising sea levels and climate change challenges. Construction began in 2003 and was scheduled for completion in 2011. The first full test was not conducted until 2020, after multiple delays, cost overruns and scandals. The project is likely to be completed this year. MOSE is designed to protect Venice and its lagoon from tides reaching up to 3 meters or 10 feet. It is a great and challenging project to protect Venice in the coming years. It protects the lower parts of the city, such as the San Marco Square. In addition to the MOSE system, Venice uses various measures to combat flooding. Infrastructure, like streets and public spaces, are being elevated, while improved water pumps and drainage systems help manage excess water. Historic buildings are being restored with water-resistant techniques, and sediment management in the lagoon helps balance water flow.
Large ships are restricted to reduce damage, and research focuses on climate adaptation. Public awareness campaigns and long-term strategies aim to address rising sea levels and climate change impacts. Combined, these efforts work to safeguard Venice's unique heritage and its resilience against future flooding.